Hey GB, I'm Alex Franks.
And I'm Freddie Hernandez.
Now today's the day that we've been waiting for the past year now, and that's going to Orlando, Florida. And we're going to take some cameras along, pack our bags, and head out and show you guys what the trip's going to be all about.
Now let's go see what Mr. Spradley has to say about the upcoming trip.
Our Florida trip's a great opportunity for the show choirs just to have a great time and bond together. Got a great long bus ride coming up, but as we do with tryouts coming up, we do this trip every 4 years. So as we prepare for this trip and students know that it's coming up, if they're a freshman, they know by the time they're a senior that they'll get to take one of these trips with the rest of the show choir. So it's a great motivation, just one of the different motivations to get students to come out to be a part of show choir. But it's just a great time. The kids have a great opportunity to see different show choirs that we'll never see ever again, that'll compete down at this festival. Just show choirs from all over the country, and they'll get to see us. So we get to get our name out there and as part of a nationwide show choir community. So it's just a great, fun trip where the students get to just sing and spend some time out in the sun and at the beach, and I'm really looking forward to it.
My name's Jacob, and I'm going to Florida, and I have 1,000 snacks in my bag. I got jalapeno chips, I got sea salt and vinegar, and I got grape juice by the dozen.
What's up?
And that's Mason, and that's Alex. Yeah.
Well, getting ready to take off for Florida. 21-hour bus ride. I'm not really looking forward to it. But one thing I am looking forward to is
cuddling up with this hunk of
Don't
beef right here.
Hey, put this in that.
That hurt my head.
Is it?
Yeah.
Real quick, this will probably be the last time I take roll with everyone. So, Nate Vanderpool, Kyle William. Is there anyone I missed? All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are about to get on our way. So, if everyone is ready, we are ready. Make sure you wave at your parents, blow them kisses, and tell them we will see them in a few days.
All right, trust Mason Jackson.
Hannah, I just Megan. Emily,
here.
Lauren,
here. Nice, nice. I like that.
Not nice.
I didn't
think so. Well, we've been on the bus for like 3 hours, and we got like 18 more to go. And it's going to be a long ride.
So as you can see, we're in Wright City, and as we watch the show choir feed in their natural habitat, what will happen next?
Hey. Deal them out.
Somebody say, pull.
It's Jacob Dietz here. We planted this cheese on this here tree, and it's expected that it'll be here to the rest of our trip. Let's find out.
We're coming back later, and we'll post a picture of this tree, and if there's cheese or no cheese on it. And if there is no cheese on it, we'll put cheese on it. And say that the cheese stayed.
It's currently 9:09. Still got 18 hours to go. It's kind of cold.
Hey, dude.
Yeah.
Fist bump.
Are you laying on the floor?
Yeah.
Alright, so you're going to lay this way, I'll be laying right here.
Room 5 is my favorite.
It is currently 12:49. We have about like 10 hours until we get to the hotel. I'm not looking forward to the rest of the night. It's hard to sleep on these seats, but just gotta make it through. It'll be all right.
Good morning, guys. We're down here in McDonald's somewhere in Georgia. It's 6:14 right now, and everybody's tired, cranky, and from that bus ride, and I just wanna go back to sleep. That's all I want to do.
Oh. Baby is pissed again.
Oh, it's like 10 o'clock right now.
Yeah.
It is currently 9:58. I don't even know where I am right now. I'm going to ask Siri real quick. Where am I?
You're on 1224 to 2102 Shiloh Road, Vienna, Georgia.
We're still in Georgia.
Yeah, so after 22 hours of being on this bus, I feel like I just finished fighting a bear. I won because we're here, but yeah, I feel like I fought a bear.
What?
How do you feel after 22 hours?
I'm tired.
In 2:41, we are here. Yeah! All right, after 22 hours of riding on this bus, we finally got back to the hotel and had an hour to shower up, get ready, and now we're on our way to downtown Disney, where we will eat a delicious meal.
And then we're really excited to get to go walk around downtown Disney and shop a lot.
Hi. We're at Planet Disney and we all have...
Where are we? Hold on.
Planet Hollywood.
Hands down, this is the most expensive
hat. How much is it?
$400.
$400?
Handmade, leathered, all on hand. So.
No fear anyway. Marry that girl, yeah, no matter.
So we just got back from downtown downtown Disney, and we're heading back to the hotel, go swim, do whatever we want, have some fun, and we'll see you guys tomorrow.
It is currently 7:10. It was a struggle getting out of bed this morning because we stayed up last night playing Super Smash Brothers, and it was really intense. But today we're going to Universal Studios. I'll see you guys then.
Yeah, so we're on our way to Universal right now. It's really good out here, nice weather.
Well guys, we just got to Universal Studios right now. We have to go through this bag check. And if you get a view of how big the line is. This is huge, there's so many people here.
Rock and Roller Coaster, it's got Jaws, it's got virtual reality stuff over here. But for those of you that are interested in Harry Potter, the Hulk, Spider-Man, it's all this way. So we will meet right here at 3:45. 3:45 right here.
But it's going to be a fun day.
We're about to eat at the Fantastic Four Cafe. Stuff looks pretty good. I might get a meatball sub.
This right here is Harry Potter. This is one of the most awesomest, craziest adventures in Universal Studios. So this is like where, like, this is like so real. Like, you can put yourself back in Harry Potter's shoes right here. Like, you can walk through it and you can imagine what it would be like in Harry Potter's time.
Hey, what's up? It's Frankie, Nate, Blake, and AJ. Just talking about what we did at Universal today. First off, we're going to have Frankie talk about what some stuff he did.
Well, if you ever come to Universal, I recommend riding the Hulk, because that was probably the best roller coaster I've ever rode in my entire life.
Like you said, the Hulk is an awesome roller coaster, except better watch out for people getting hit by ducks, because that actually happened today. But I would also recommend the Spider-Man ride.
Yeah, I mean, we visited Hogwarts and did all that stuff over there. That was pretty cool. Had some butter beer, tasted pretty good. And yeah, had a really good time.
I mean, I was with them the whole day, so pretty much the same thing. But I recommend the Hulk and Hogwarts, just because it's pretty cool. Alright, next we're going to be going to the hotel, getting freshened up, you know. We're going to go into a dinner theater. It's going to be dope. It's going to be great. We're going to have some great food there.
Well, it's day two. We spent the whole day at Universal this morning. Not too many sunburns, just a few little ones, so I'm not too worried about that. Everybody had a great time at Islands of Adventure, and everybody's been fantastic. We had a really quick turnaround, and most everybody's down here for our trip to the Sluice Dinner Theater, so that's what's coming up. So everybody's dressed up in their Sunday best, and everybody looks awesome. But we got two more full days, so it's going great. I'm really tired, but I wouldn't change anything. We've got a great group of kids, and I'm loving it.
Hey, we're at Sleuth's Mystery Dinner. This is day two of our Florida trip, basically, and it's been pretty awesome going up to this, but we're ready to perform and go to the beach.
Hey, my name is Robert Wright, and I'm a professional actor here in Orlando, Florida. Right now we're at the Sleuth, which is why I have this awesome shirt on right now. I just finished the show called The Premiere.
Let's rule out Henry real quick. Ruling out Henry because of the question I asked. The question I asked was that if, whenever he came back in and asked if he needed to do CPR, that entitles that he did not know that he was shot with a blow dart gun. So that's ruling out Henry. He did not know that he was shot with a blow dart gun because he asked to do CPR. So that ruled out Henry. Now we go on to Nikki. Nikki was my life.
She was in the hallway where the blow dart came from.
She was one of the people that came out.
She has 1,000 reasons to kill him.
Yeah, because she killed his boyfriend. She can't really break up with him. And she needs money. So there's three reasons.
Explain what happened. She got out and stopped her. Mm-hmm. Explained.
I don't think Nikki's really dumb. I think she's freaking being dumb.
I think it's all that.
Hey GV, this is Alex Franks, and I'm here with Robert. And Robert, how many shows do you think you perform a week?
Oh, right now I just started here, so I'm only doing maybe like two a week.
And do you think you'll further your acting career?
Yes. I mean, I act around town a lot, and I work at a lot of professional theaters. And I mean, I just got hired here, but I mean, I'm still doing a lot of work around town, so yeah.
You go and learn a couple of the parts so you can jump in on different plays. Because like you said, we got 15 shows, and you got some people who know all of them, they hop in and out of all the shows.
So we just got done with the Sleuth's Mystery Dinner, and that was honestly pretty awesome. Now we're going back to the hotel, and me and my gang are gonna go play a crap ton of Mario Kart. But so far this trip has been really awesome.
Well guys, it is currently day three of our Orlando trip. I'm currently getting ready to perform with our show choir at Apopka High School. It's about half an hour away. And I'm really nervous because I haven't practiced my solo in about 3 days. And I think we might rehearse it once and then it's showtime, so it's pretty nerve-wracking, but I know it'll all turn out well. And right after, we're going to Universal Studios for day two, and it's going to be awesome.
We're on our way to Apopka High School and kind of nervous because my hair is not done and I didn't know we were supposed to curl it, so doing that right now. And I think it'll be great, and then I'm excited for Universal the rest of the night, so it'll be good.
I'm feeling really good about today. I feel like we'll do pretty good. I'm excited for Universal afterwards.
Excited to ride rides that I haven't rode yet. And I feel like today is going to be a good day.
We're going to walk around the building. When we go inside the building, you're going past the auditorium. So use your really small mouse inside voices. And then I'll tell you when you can be rowdy again. Deal?
Deal.
All right, follow me.
Sonia, wait.
How does it feel that it's your last competition?
I mean, I'm kind of nervous about it. I want everything to go well, but I know it won't be the last time I'm performing with you guys, so I'll be fine.
You know, it's more surreal than anything. It's kind of weird. After 4 years of high school, this is my last Joe Bar performance. It's weird.
So we just performed our last show here in Orlando, Florida, and it's been a ride. Been with the
this bar for 4 years, 3 years, and it's just, can't thank Sprat enough for all he's done for us.
It's kind of tough letting it go, you know. Last one, it's hard to think it's all over now.
Okay, I'm here with Carly, a.k.a. Monica, and she is from Amplified, and I'm going to ask her, how did you feel after the performance, and how do you think you did?
I feel like all the girls left all they had on the floor, and we had a lot of fun. Everybody did a lot of facials and added so much to the show. I felt like we did really good.
That's great.
All right, so we just got done performing. It was pretty cool. It was on a flat stage, so it was a little different, but I think we did really well. I hope we get first because, you know, it's my last competition, and I just thought it went really well.
The secret is you need speed, power, and accuracy all together. You're gonna wanna, I do it like this, but you lose a lot of control by holding it on the end.
But I got a lot of control.
So when you're swinging, you wanna do it fast and strong. So you're gonna take it.
That's what I'm saying.
Whatevs, forget you guys.
Wait, I bet you got Mac.
Well, this pretty much wraps up our weekend here in Orlando. Besides the beach tomorrow, we took first in both choirs. Thank you to all the boosters and the parents that helped make this happen. Thank you, Sprad and Ms. Harvey, for being great leaders. That's about it.
Yeah. I just want to say, love all you guys back home, and we'll see you soon. Talk to you later.
Well guys, today is our last day in Florida. We got all our room packed and we're about to head out to load the buses. It's sad to see this place go, but we know we have to come home sometime, right? But today we're gonna go to Ron Johnson's shop for a little bit and then we're gonna get to the beach, Cocoa Beach, for about 3 hours, then we're on our way home.
I am
flying. Go that, buddy.
Let's go.
The view is beautiful out here.
Where are we going, Kylie?
We're going upstairs!
When are we going?
Right now!
We just got these matching hats. I hate it.
Alright, we just got done shopping at Ron John's. My buddy Brett and I just got these bucket hats, so if you see us around the valley wearing these, you know where we got them. Now we're gonna go eat and go to the beach.
All right, this is Troy Spradley reporting live from Cocoa Beach. We're on the last leg of our show choir trip. It's been fantastic. We just left our hotel this morning, just spent some time at Ron John's Surf Shop. Everybody bought some great souvenirs. As you can see, the ocean is beautiful, the sun is shining. This is the last thing we do before we head back home, so most of the kids are already out in the ocean. It's been great. I'm gonna head out there myself, so you guys, we will see you back in the valley.
Hey, it's Jacob Dietz. I'm here in Florida with Grain Valley Exclamation, and this is my first time I've ever been to a beach. It's beautiful out here. I mean, the water's great. It's beautiful outside, and it's just an awesome experience. If you've never been, I suggest you go.
All right. I mean, there's nothing much to say. It's the beach. I mean, beautiful. Everything's just beautiful. It's like a blind spot, like I got caught. Salt water, like a teardrop
with the salt water heart. Ooh. I'm here with Nate Vanderpool. Nate, how are you enjoying the beach right now?
You know, I'm enjoying it pretty well. The waves feel great, the water feels great. And, you know, I just want to give a quick shout out to Bailey and Brenna Critchison for burying me in the sand and for this awesome idea. I'm actually kind of comfortable.
Are you good? Hey, it's Jacob Dietz. We're with the choir and we're leaving Orlando right now. I'm just packing up my stuff and for this 25-hour drive home.
Hey guys, we're eating dinner here at Wendy's, and I don't know, just got back from the beach, and from a bus ride about an hour to get here. It's been pretty good. Got pretty sunburnt. I think we all did. Yeah. And I have 21 more hours, I think, till home. So this is up next.
Yeah, 19 hours to go before we get back to that terrible place called Missouri. And, yeah.
Currently 5:07. We have about 8 hours to go. Everyone's sunburnt, so it's really hard to sleep, but we just need to hang in there. We're almost done.
Hey, we're at a McDonald's outside of St. Louis, and this is going to be our last stop before we get back to Green Valley. And I can easily say this is one of the most lovely trips of my life. I felt gross on my hand.
Hey guys, we are now about 10 minutes away from home. It's really sad to see this place go, because I know the minute I step off the bus, vacation's over, but Florida will always have a part of my heart. It was an amazing experience. I had a lot of incredible memories made.